Hello and welcome to Kimber Bushcraft. Yes, I'm making a new video out here from my camp, and the reason for that is because some of you know that I'm working on a school, and all the schools in Denmark are actually closed because of the coronavirus. So I have a lot of spare time and a lot of project I can do. So as you saw in my beginning here, I made a new sheath for my SE5. And that was a little nice project I made a couple of days ago, and I actually made a video about how I did that, so I hope you like. I'm still planning of making my video this weekend from a forest here in Denmark, so all of you who's looking forward to that, I think the weather will be nice, so I'll definitely do that too. But today it's a wonderful day, the sun is shining. But at the moment, the trees are shading for the sun, so it doesn't come down here in my shelter, and that's good for the recordings, the footage. And of course, I'm going to make me a cup of coffee out here, and I will make it on my Svea stove. I saw a guy on YouTube making an improvement of that little stove, and I would like to show you that I made the same, and it makes it much easier to fire up. So I hope you enjoy. And it's gonna be a short video out here. The video with my DIY project knife sheath is about 14 minutes long. So I hope you enjoy, so stay on.
Thank you.
Well, this is my video from my DIY project of this sheath for my SE5. My goal was to make it look old school and also old. I've used sandpaper on the leather before I dyed it and after also. So it has this surface. It's not completely matte, but it's not completely glossy too. And I don't like glossy leather surfaces. So my intention was that it should look like a knife sheath I had had for a long time, have used for a long time. And I think I've succeeded in that very well. And my video is not completely a go through how I make this sheath, but I hope you have got an idea of the process in this, and perhaps you have perhaps you want to make one yourself, and you can use my video as inspiration. Well, thank you for watching this. I hope you enjoyed. Yeah, take a look at this. A little leather perth from a company called Stanwell. And some of you, a few of you, probably know what this is. And the rest of you are going to be a little bit wiser now, because this is a pipe brand. It's a pipe brand, and I love those pipes they made. This one is a 75 years anniversary model, and I found it on their website, and I just got in love with this pipe. Here is a little thing out of silver, and that's why it's not a cheap pipe. I think it's the most expensive I ever bought. Don't tell my wife. So of course I've tried it, so it's not brand new. I got it yesterday and I had to smoke it right away, of course. But I think it's a cool little pipe. I have something similar to this from Savinelli, and that is one of my favorite pipes too. I love it. The shape of it is old school, I think. So now let's fire it up here for the first time in my Kimber camp. And almost every time I upload a new video, I have some questions about the tobacco I use. And this tobacco is called Red Orlik Golden Slice tobacco. And I think it's a very nice tobacco. It's not cheap and it's not expensive. It's just in the middle and it has a good taste. And can hold a spark for a very long time. That's important when you're a pipe smoker. It doesn't just puff off and then you're finished. So, but I also like Captain Black from America. We can't get that in Denmark. And actually there was a subscriber that was sending me some tobacco, and the Danish Customs Service actually sent it back to him because I am not allowed to import tobacco in Denmark. Ridiculous. But that's the way it is. So now my tobacco is in my new pipe, and then I'm going to light it up out here, and I'm really looking forward to that. I'm not 100% sure, but I think Stanwell is a Danish company that makes these awesome pipes. I have had a lot of them during my time as a pipe smoker, and it's always good quality they make. And this one is especially because it's an anniversary model. So I love it. And the silver part here, I think it's so cool. Yeah, and now as you can see, I processed quite a bit of firewood. So the only thing I'm missing now is down here. I want to make a long fire next time I'm out here in a camp. Just focus down here. So that is my wish, and I'll take this stick with me. It's going to be almost as long as this one. So now I'm going up into the woods and cut a part of the tree I fell for some months ago. Yeah, and now it's time for coffee. With my little Svea. Optimus Svea. And my little kettle from Eagle Products. And this is my improvement of the Optimus Svea stove. A little piece of glass fiber wick that I bought in a shop and just put it around there.
And the reason for that is when I come approximately half of one of those, come them in here, the fluid, the fuel will burn much better and up around. That's the way. So it's staying there and will actually warm it up much more efficient. So you can see it's all located around there, and the Optimus Rare is going to be preheated, as they call it, and when it's going to burn down, I can start this one, and sometime, if you're lucky, it will start it yourself, or else you have to just lit it up. There we are. Now it's burning, and I can begin to cook my water. Just going to put this over. Like this.
Skål. Well, this is all for now, folks. I hope you enjoyed this little video. Because this video is not planned, I made it as an extra. I decided to not answer your comments. Unless there's a question, of course I will answer that, but again, I got a lot of comments and I use a lot of time for that, so this video I'll only read it and mark it with a little heart, so you know I've seen your comments. I hope you understand that. And of course, if you have a question, I'll answer that. So now I'm going home and edit this video, and today's Thursday, and it will launch on YouTube this evening. And Saturday, I think I'll go out in part of Roll Forest that I've been before, but now the spring is near, and I think this part of the forest will be very cool to be in. So I hope you like. And again, thank you for watching Kimmy Bushcraft. I really appreciate that. All your comments and all your kindness. Thank you so much. See you on the next one. Bye bye and take care.